Welcome back to the weekend here on Sports Radio 910. Anthony Opperman with you. And, you know, as everybody who's followed along with this show knows, I always like to close out the show with a little bit of Texas country music. And there is one band in particular that has certainly made plenty of appearances at the end of the show, and that is Reckless Kelly. They're going to be in town on Monday night, partnering with the Flying Squirrels and the Miracle League, and hopefully going to raise some money for the Miracle League. And join us now from Reckless Kelly, one of the members of the band, Cody Braun. Cody, first and foremost, thank you for taking the time. Really appreciate it.
Hey, no problem, man. I'm glad to be here.
Well, Cody, first and foremost, I guess for everybody in Richmond, give us a little bit of background about Reckless Kelly and how you guys got started.
We started out in Oregon, actually, in 95. Kind of got the band together there and then moved to Austin in 96 and been down in Austin ever since. And just been, you know, we moved to Austin just to kind of get our sound together, and there was a lot of places to play down there and kind of fit our musical style a lot better than Oregon did. And it was just a great place for us to kind of get rolling and get started on stuff. So we've had a lot of success down there, and now we've been out touring the States for about 12 years or so, and finally starting to build crowds up everywhere, and it's going really good.
You know, you bring up the fact that, you know, you guys have had some opportunities to play a little bit in Austin. I'm trying to tell people here, because obviously I'm from Texas, I'm trying to tell people here what kind of a big deal Reckless Kelly is in Texas, and you know, just the following that you guys have, and just Texas country music as a whole. I mean, it's a really interesting genre, and I just love the fact, you know, when I go back home, that, you know, the radio stations there are supporting the local music, and it really is a great environment to get started in.
Yeah, you know, I mean, a lot of the guys that we grew up listening to and were influenced by growing up are from Texas, and we grew up listening to a lot of their music, so. You know, to move down there and get to meet them and become friends with a few of them and get to play music with guys like, you know, Joe Healy and Steve Earle, and you know, get to see guys like Guy Clark and play with Robert Earl Keen and all those kind of guys that we grew up listening to, and to get to just you know, get to see them play, and then, like I said, get to play with them was just incredible. And you know, it is a unique scene down there. It's a lot of, you know, it's more of a music scene than a business scene. You know, Nashville is always kind of about the music business, and Austin has always been just kind of a more of a musician friendly town, I guess, you know, where musicians can play, and you know, there's not a whole lot of, you know, focus on the business as much as there is the just playing music and enjoying it.
Cody Braun from the band Reckless Kelly joined us here on the weekend, and Cody, you know, you bring up some of those guys that influence you. Willie Nelson happened to be on that list?
Yeah, absolutely. We were hanging out with him last night, actually. We had a night off in Charleston, and he happened to be playing, and our road manager is a buddy of his road manager, and so we got to go hang out backstage and watch the show, and it was just awesome. We've done several shows with Willie over the years, but it was fun last night just getting to sit and watch. He's so great.
And Cody Braun from Reckless Kelly joined us here on the weekend. And Cody, you guys are coming to Richmond on Monday. You're going to be at the Canal Club downtown.
Yeah.
But before you're there, I think it's worth noting that you guys are traveling up and down the East Coast, including a stop in D.C., right?
Yeah, we're in D.C. tonight, and we're going to be up in New York City tomorrow night, and then in Connecticut, in Norfolk, Connecticut, night on Sunday, and then with you guys on Monday. So,
well, kind of how this all relates to sports talk shows, the fact that you guys have been real big into helping raise money for youth sports and the Miracle League back in Austin. I know you guys do that annual softball jam, which is really an awesome celebration of music and sports, and all for a good cause to raise money for little leagues. Just talk a little bit about that and how that whole thing came together with the Round Rock Express, the AAA affiliate for the Texas Rangers.
Well, my brother and I were up at a Round Rock Express game 4 years ago, I guess 5 years ago, and we were just watching the game and hanging out, and we got to meet Reed and Reese Ryan. They own the team down there, and we just were talking about how much fun it'd be to come and play a baseball game on that field. It's just a beautiful field. And they were like, well, let's do it, you know. And then we got to talk a little bit more. We're like, gosh, we could, you know, invite our buddies to play music who never get to play baseball. And so it kind of just started from there. And then, you know, we decided we'd try and do a softball game and a concert and, you know, just make it a lot of fun and try and raise some money for Little League. And then we got introduced to the Miracle League through the Round Rock Express, too. And just an incredible organization, you know, helping special needs kids play baseball. And, you know, I think a lot of people take for granted the fact that, you know, most kids can just get up and play baseball. And it's just, you know, they take it for granted. But, you know, for these kids that are in wheelchairs and walkers and, you know, that can't really have that opportunity for them to be able to just be on a team and play a game of baseball is really, really cool. So we're really proud to be part of that. And the Round Rock Express folks have been really great. And the event has grown, you know, just immensely over the last 4 years. We had, I think, about 7,000 people show up this year. And over the years, we've raised over, you know, probably about $120,000 or $130,000 for, you know, Austin Little League and the Miracle League. So really, really proud to be doing that, and it's a lot of fun for everybody.
Talk about some of the other sports venues. I mean, you guys have done, like, the National Anthem, playing the Star Spangled Banner for some pretty major sporting events, huh?
Yeah, we set a goal a couple years ago, my brother and I, to try to do the anthem in every major league park in the country. So I think we've got 9 marked off the list, and we're doing St. Louis in July, so that'll be 10. So we're making a pretty good dent in it, and we just started a few years ago. So, yeah, we love doing the anthem, and you get some pretty good seats with that gig as well.
Hey, what do you know off the top of your head? What are the other 9 that you've been at?
We've done, obviously, the Texas Rangers and the Astros. We've done the Braves, Chicago Cubs, Brewers, Diamondbacks, the Rockies. Let me see. There's a few more in there, but I've got my list.
That's awesome, man. That's awesome. And Cody Braun from the band Reckless Kelly join us here on the weekend. They're going to be in town on Monday at the Canal Club, not only doing a concert, but also a meet and greet with Flying Squirrels players and coaches from 6:30 to 7:30. Fans can donate $5 to the Miracle League in order to take advantage of that. And Cody, before I let you go, I think it's worth telling the story about how you and your brother Willie got connected with Parney, because it was really a random situation.
It really was. We were playing at a club there in Richmond, and we were at a little Irish pub down the street having some lunch, and Parney and one of the owners for the Squirrels came in, and they were sitting next to us at the bar, and they were kind of talking shop, talking business, and we overheard, you know, they're talking baseball, and Parney's wearing his Squirrels jersey, and we're like, hey, you guys in baseball? And we said, yeah, and they said, yeah, and so we asked them if they knew the Ryans. They said, oh, yeah, of course we do. And we started talking about the softball jam and then music, and before we knew it, we were fast friends.
And certainly Shanae benefited that night, and the Hat Factory did as well. And no doubt that the Canal Club and Post Pub will benefit coming up this Monday in addition to the Miracle League.
Yeah, you know, I mean, Barney's been so great, and everybody at the Squirrels, you know, we were down there earlier this year and did, or I guess last year, it was in the fall, we sang God Bless America and got to see the park and got the full tour. And like I said, you guys have just been great, and it's just been a lot of fun getting to know everybody there in Richmond, and, you know, getting to come there and play music and see some baseball is right up our alley. So,
well, Cody,
you guys.
Well, we certainly are look forward to Monday. It's going to be a great time, and this is definitely a treat for me, obviously, being from Texas and, you know, growing up listening to Texas country music. Always appreciate it. Have you guys have your CD in my car right now. So Parney and I have been jamming out, getting everybody here in Richmond ready for some Reckless Kelly. And, again, can't wait to see you guys on Monday. Have a good rest of the trip, and we'll catch up soon.
All right, man. Thanks so much. We'll see you soon.
Yeah, that's Cody Braun from Reckless Kelly. Join us here on the weekend with Anthony Opperman. For more information about their concert, you can log on to squirrelsbaseball.com. Or to purchase tickets, log on to thecanalclub.com. I promise you, you're going to want to hear them. They're great. Stay tuned. We've got more coming up here on the weekend.
The Weekend with Anthony Opperman continues next on Sports Radio 910.